My name is Ghislain Kofi Nyaku from Togo. I'm Director of Protection of Human Rights in an NGO, Group of Association Against Impunity in Togo. The transitional justice process was initiated in my country to set the painful past of violence and violation of human rights that the country experienced at the age of independence until the coming of power of Fanny Asimbe, that is to say from 1978 to 2005. To this day, it was created a Truth Commission, Justice and Reconciliation. The commission listened to victims throughout the country, and a report which includes 4 volumes was released. Only one of the reports made public contains 68 recommendations. I hope that by combining their efforts, civil society organizations have an undeniable impact on the success of the transitional justice process in Togo. The Group of Association Against Impunity in Togo, held from June 2 to 10, 2011, a forum with various stakeholders on the theme, which contribution of civil society for lasting reconciliation in Togo. Coming out of this meeting, a synergy of civil society organization was created to accompany the process of transitional justice in the country. This initiative gave birth to the civic platform Justice and Truth. Under the coordination of CACIT, this platform works for awareness of reconciliation and peace, manual production and communication tools sharing, education for citizenship, youth engagement, competition on peace, conflict prevention, operationalization of an early warning mechanisms, especially at election time, outreach and dissemination of the report of CVJR in easy French in communities, advocacy for the implementation of the recommendation of the CVJR. The CACIT has at the heart of its actions the situation of victims. So the association provides assistance to victims of violations of human rights and torture in Togo. This support consists on sensitization on human rights and the process of the transitional justice in the country, legal assistance to the national, regional and international protection of human rights mechanisms, a psychological and medical assistance to victims of torture, a social assistance to victims, advocacy for improvement of the legal and institutional framework to fight against impunity that leads, for example, to the adoption of a new criminal law criminalizing torture according to international convention. Advocacy for the enforcement of court decision, including the ECOWAS Community Court. Our main challenge today are effective implementation of the recommendations, execution of judicial decision of Community Court of ECOWAS, for example, fight against impunity, constitutional reforms in order to ensure peace according to the CVJR recommendations.